I've always been fascinated by space since I was a little kid. I grew up in central Pennsylvania, so we had really dark skies, and I would spend, you know, since I was five, I would spend the nights outside with my father looking at the stars, and that inspired me to want to work for NASA since I was a young kid. My name is Greer Wilt, and I'm an engineer at the NASA Johnson Space Center in Houston, Texas. I have three main roles at NASA. One of those is a CAPCOM, or a capsule communicator. That is the voice of mission control. The other role is serving as the pressurized rover flight operations lead. And the pressurized rover is, think like an RV for the moon. It's gonna enable crewed exploration of the lunar surface. And then the last role is a spacewalk flight controller and instructor. So a spacewalk is when an astronaut wears a big white spacesuit and leaves on ISS, the space station, and performs maintenance. On the lunar surface, the spacewalks will be to conduct exploration and science objectives on the moon. One of the projects I'm working on is the pressurized rover, which is, again, pressurized mobile habitation element for the lunar surface, and spacewalk training and flight control for spacewalks on the moon. That's incredibly challenging. On previous Apollo missions, we were at the mid-latitude regions. In the lunar south pole, you could step into a shadow and be negative 250 degrees Fahrenheit, or the sun could be directly glaring at you in a much higher temperature environment. So we're just figuring out how we're gonna conduct spacewalks in that really challenging environment and explore, see if we can find water. We found evidence of water at the lunar south pole, which we could hopefully extract for not only drinking water, but also to use for fuel. Which would be great and could allow us to sustain operations so that we could stay much longer on the lunar surface. Space exploration can solve a lot of problems that help humanity here on Earth. So for instance, if we have orbiting satellites, that can help provide data on farming, on maritime law, tracking of species, for instance, which helps understanding how our environment can be more healthy and thrive. I went to Germany as part of the RISE program, Research Internships in Science and Engineering, as part of DAAD, in 2007 at the University of Freiburg at the Institute for Microsystems Technology there. There, I was working on microelectrodes, so specifically to smooth the brain-machine interface for prosthetics. The DAAD provided this research internship in science and engineering internship for me. It was such a great opportunity. It really just opened up my world to a new way of thinking. It gave me independence to thrive in an environment that was completely different and I had to rely on others. I think it's a great growth opportunity, and in a world right now where there's like a lot of contention between individuals or different disciplines, it allows us to collaborate and focus on something positive like science or engineering that is a positive impact on the world. My career aspirations for the future are just to continue to contribute to human spaceflight exploration. Again, it's something I'm really passionate about. I think it's something that transcends borders. If I could go on any space mission, I would first be happy to go on any space mission if I could, but I'm really intrigued by Mars. And the reason being is that, one, we've never been there, so it's the very first time. It's incredibly challenging to get there. And lastly, there could be life, right? So performing those same spacewalk operations, we could find something that completely transforms our understanding of humanity and our solar system and universe. So being a part of that would be really cool.